Acts, God gives Peter the power to heal a crippled beggar.
But you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes on you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem and in Judea and Samaria and to the ends of the earth. Acts 1 verse 8. Acts 3.
One day, Peter and John were on their way to the temple to pray. When they came close to one of the gates leading to the temple, Peter and John met a man who'd been a cripple from birth. He could never walk, and every day he waited by the temple gates, begging from those who came into the temple court.
When he saw Peter and John, he asked them for money. Peter and John stopped next to him, looking straight at him, and Peter said,
"I do not have any silver or gold or money to give you, but I can give you this. In the name of Jesus of Nazareth, get up and walk."
Peter took his hand and helped him to stand up. And instantly the man's feet and ankles became strong, and for the first time ever, he could stand on his own.
I can stand! I can walk!
The man cried, rejoicing in God who has healed him. He went with Peter and John into the temple courts, jumping and praising God. When all the people saw him walking and praising God, they recognized him as the same man who used to be sitting at the temple gate, begging for money. And they were amazed at what had happened to him.
Here we discover that the Holy Spirit helps us to be bold and brave so that we can share His love with others. After the miracle, Peter preached the gospel to those who gathered in the temple court. He explained how important and special it was that Jesus Christ had died and had risen again. Miracles are signs pointing us toward God. Miracles are not for our entertainment, but they demonstrate the love and power of God. Through the power of the Holy Spirit, we can do the same things that Jesus did. We live by faith. It says so in John 14, verse 12.
Memorize. Then Peter said, "Silver and gold I do not have, but what I have I give to you. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, walk." Acts 3, verse 6.